We had to wait before attacking the forge again. We clearly were not ready. We can shoot straight and at decent armor, but would that have been enough against pyromaniac in a fort? I don't think so. I'm glad everyone pointed that flaw in my plan. I was so confident after stopping both the Rust Devils and the Mechanist. So we went into all military bases. I still had my keycard for the National Guard training yard, as I was affected there after the Battle of Anchorage. We found ourselves pretty neat combat armors. The place was filled of ghouls though. Back home, Sturgess, along with MacCready and others, decided to make them look scarier. If we make them fear us just by seeing us, the fight will be easier, they said. I never thought about that. They're right. I remember the first time I fought Super Mutants. I could barely move because of their imposing presence. So we made the armors black and painted the scary cat face on the helmets. We didn't have enough helmet for everyone, but we collected a bunch of acid gas masks on raiders who were attacking our settlements. It will help with all the smoke and the disgusting smell of theirs. For myself, the scavengers repaired the old power armor I picked up in Concord, back when I was helping Preston, Sturgess, DeLongs and the crazy old lady. The helmet was broken and couldn't be repaired, but we salvaged the helmet of one of the Rust Devils. It looks like a T-60 helmet. I didn't have the time to see many of them before the bombs, but they are sturdier than the one I had. We painted it as close as we could from the regular armor everyone else would use. I feel bad about having more protection than them, but they said that since I'm the general, I don't know who decided that I was, I should wear something more imposing. I finally agreed. As a reminder of Preston, we made the entrance of the armory a Minuteman memorial. It's not much, but I hope Preston can see it and knows we still think about him. Same for our main rifles. They're all painted on the Minuteman colors, so somehow the Forge will know why we attacked them once again. People were picking more and more interest in other domains than their usual jobs. Jason agreed to let them know a bit about anatomy and chemistry, but his office was too small, so on top of the armory, we made a school. I know, it sounds crazy, but we have people of knowledge here, and they won't live forever, so passing their knowledge to others can be a good thing. That's how we rebuild society. We decided to close off this part of the settlement. That way we have a safe place to hide our weakest citizen during attacks. And it's pleasant to hang out there. We also made a library with all the books that we were still able to read. For that, we repurposed the house there, and we'll have to build a new home for the people who live there. Life begins to be pleasant out here. I even prefer it as what I knew before the apocalypse. Though if you excuse me, I need to summon the War Council before we head toward the Forge.